A cis person has been cast in a trans role again. The latest in this age-old casting trend is Scarlett Johansson, who's reuniting with her Ghost in the Shell director to, once again, erase a marginalized community. She'll play Dante Tex Gill, a real-life trans man and massage parlor owner in the movie Rub and Tug. A cis person in a trans role is and always has been a problem. Allow me, a trans person and culture critic, to break down why. For one, it deprives trans actors of work. Cis actors have far more advantages and access in Hollywood than trans folks do. There's no shortage of unbelievably talented trans actors who never get the chance to play or even audition for trans parts that go directly to more famous cis leads. But there's another huge reason cis people shouldn't play trans, especially right now. It has harmful consequences in the real world, where trans and non-binary people don't have the same legal protections and human rights as cis people, and where trans women, especially trans women of color, are murdered at increasing rates, often because of the way media misrepresents them. When cis people play trans characters, it sends the message that being trans is just a performance. When Eddie Redmayne and Jared Leto and Jeffrey Tambor play these parts, it tells audiences that trans women are just men in dresses, which of course they're not. A brief look at Hollywood history shows that transmasculine people like me rarely, if ever, get represented on screen. And when we do, it's Hilary Swank and Daniela C and Scarlett Johansson and Rachel Weisz. They get to portray us. Cis women in those roles suggest trans men are just butch women disguised as men. And that's not true. Cis actors playing us delegitimizes our identity, reduces us to dangerous stereotypes, and fails to capture the nuance and truth of who we are. And when cis actors win awards for playing trans, they're called courageous and brave. Not to say those people aren't talented, but there's nothing brave about you mimicking our lives. Being trans is not an acting exercise, and no longer can it be a cis actor's quick ticket to an award. Sure, an A-lister like Johansson guarantees bigger box office than a lesser-known trans lead. But more audiences seeing an inaccurate parody of who we are is more damaging than doing it right. Plus, who's to say a film with an unknown minority lead won't make it to the Oscars? Just look at Moonlight and A Fantastic Woman. And that is the perfect model of what Hollywood needs to do more of. If Hollywood starts casting trans actors in all types of roles, trans and cis, leading and supporting, then those actors have a chance to grow and become household names. And hopefully, one day, play an Avenger like Johansson. Right now, it's essential for trans people to tell their own stories, on camera and behind it. To all the cis actors out there, like Johansson, now is the time to use your platform to elevate us.